non-Hodgkin's lymphoma, and I had went to the doctor because I found a lump in my leg, and they told me it was a hernia, and set me up with a surgeon, and went to see him, and it was in North Kansas City, and he also operates in Liberty on Thursday and Friday, so he was going to go on vacation. He says a femur hernia needs to be removed, and he was going to go on vacation, so he said it'd be another week. So on August the 7th of 2008, they did the surgery, and when I was coming out of recovery, you know how they the nurse records what's going on in her little whatever, you know, and you're kind of hearing it, you know. And she was telling about this, you know, talking in the recorder about the surgery and everything, and said about the femoral hernia removed and a biopsy of something. And I'm thinking,
why would they do a biopsy?
Biopsy? What's she talking about? So, you know, I'm in pain. So they get me up to the room, and Bob comes in right after that, a little while after that, and he said, I raised up and I said, what are you talking about? Something about a biopsy. He said, they found an inflamed lymph node and they're going to do a biopsy on it. I said, okay. Wait a minute, this is something I ought to be concerned about. He said, they're going to do a biopsy on it. And so, anyway, I just kind of let it go with that. You know, I mean, I didn't know what. And so then the next morning, the surgeon came in and wanted to know if I'd like to go home. And I said, yeah. And, of course, I don't know if anybody, I'd never had a surgery like that before. So I wasn't prepared for how painful it was, how hard it was to walk. I mean, you know, I just wasn't prepared for all that. But I was ready to go home. And so, anyway, he told me about the operation and about the inflamed lymph node, and he said, I may have results of it by Tuesday or Wednesday if you want to call. Otherwise, you're coming to my office on Friday, and we'll discuss whatever. So I decided not to call because it was bad news. I didn't want to hear it, and it was good news. I could wait. So then when we went for the appointment, he went with me for everything. When we went for the appointment, then he told me, he showed me the results printed out, that it was cancer. It was non-Hodgkin's lymphoma. And he said it's very treatable. And so then he gave us a list of, I think there's five doctors over at Heartland Hematology. And so when we got in the car, Bob called my Sunday school teacher, which has been a nurse for 40 years, and asked which of these five would she recommend. And she said Dr. DeWolf. So that's who we went to. And then from there it was, let's see, which was first, the PET scan or the bone? I think the PET scan was first.
I think so, too.
But it was, by this time, it was coming up on Labor Day. And the mobile unit only comes on Monday, so it was like waiting another week to do the PET scan. And PET scan, did they call us or what about it?
I can't remember.
I can't remember when we went back to the doctor. If we went for all the tests.
It seemed like we learned it all.
When we went back to the oncologist. So then he scheduled a bone marrow biopsy, which is not fun. No fun. And so Bob, he come back there. He says, I'm going to hold her hand. And the nurse said, you wait over here. I'll hold her hand. All I saw was this. Of course, they came in. The guy came in. And he said that these have got a real bad rep because oncologist has been, you know, usually does them, used to do them. And he may only do one a month. But he said, I do them every day, all day long. So.
They're real professional now.
Yeah,
so they,
and so it wasn't nearly, but I had never heard anything about them, so I wasn't prepared for any of the bad stuff anyway. When I saw that needle, I'm thinking, oh my gosh. About that time though, I was out, so. But then when we went to the oncologist, he suggested to have radiation. So I went to the radiation oncologist, and he reviewed everything and decided on 23 radiation treatments. So I went every day except Saturday and Sunday for 23 days and had the radiation. And the only bad part about that was side effects weren't fun. And it was very tiring, but I only worked 3 days a week, so I went to work every day. And by about the 19th, I really started getting bad burned. And so by the 23rd one, which was my birthday, was my last radiation treatment, I had third degree burns by that time. But, you know, they gave me stuff to treat that, and I've been in remission ever since.
And faith's so, been a big part of your journey.
Oh, yes. A lot of people pray.
Yes. Yeah, from the time we first, she first found that lump that we were afraid it was cancer, which was really just the hernia. But from that time, you know, I was concerned, so I started praying for her then, and really made it a big, much time in prayer about it ever since then. So I felt extremely thankful that that the Lord chose to cause things to happen the way he did. So in a way, it's good that she had the hernia, because wouldn't have learned about the lymph node being inflamed and having the cancer in there, if it hadn't been the hernia to go in there, and he ran across it while he was in there. Mm-hmm. So it was a real interesting way things happen, and blessing and situation, and it's been interesting to work together, the two of us praying and going through this, and then been trying to, then from that we can be encouragement to others, I guess. But it's been quite interesting.
How did you get involved with Relay for Life?
Claire Johnson called me and talked to me about this, because I was on a church prayer list. So then she found out why, so she called me. And I had heard of it, but I know one night I thought I would go before this ever, you know, like a year before, but I was working, and so I didn't. But down at Big V, we always have the sheets of deals that people in memory, or what's the other one, in memory of somebody, or in honor of. And so you can put five or one or dollars or however many, I think it's $1 or $5. And then we'd hang them up on the window as you come in the store. And so I always thought that was a real neat deal. And this one gal, 1 year, her and I had this contest of how many people we could encourage to do that, you know, so that was fun. But, of course, then afterwards, I've always went walked afterwards because of, you know, and I think it's a great deal. I wish even more people would participate in it. It's a fun evening. It's a great way to raise money. And even though there's been a lot of money donated over the years for cancer research, and they haven't found a cure.
For very much of it.
It's
amazing.
Yeah.
It's amazing the stuff they have done.
But the advancement in tests and treatments is phenomenal. I mean, you know, it's great. So keep giving.
What did it mean to you to walk on that survivor's lap the first time?
Very emotional.
What about for you to join her on the caregiver's lap?
I didn't quite understand your question.
Did you join her on the caregiver's lap?
This last time. What have you been? That was the third one, wasn't it? The first two, had other things going on. I wasn't able to attend, but I was able to attend this last one. Yes, I'd spent a long evening this last time with him. We had a good time, participated in all of it.
He spent a lot of time over at the silent auction.
Got some good stuff.
Anything you can say to encourage others struggling with cancer right now?
Don't give up and be faithful in finding good physicians and pray.